Hi, I'm Oscar Granados.
And I'm Isabella Teodorovich. Today is Friday, December 7, 2018.
Welcome back to Braddock TV. Every year, Braddock hosts a 5K breast cancer walk to raise money and awareness for breast cancer, a disease that affects one in every 8 women in America.
Here's Vanessa with more on this year's 5K walk.
Hey Bulldogs, we are at Braddock's second annual Breast Cancer Walk. At this event, students have the opportunity to be a part of the fight against breast cancer. Students and adults can participate by donating and walking around the school twice. All funds raised are to support the National Breast Cancer Research Foundation.
The Breast Cancer Research Foundation is a nonprofit organization that takes 92% of our donation money and takes it to research to find a cure for breast cancer.
I think it's very important for people to donate to this cause in order to raise funds for people that do have breast cancer. It's not always, well, it actually isn't a cheap treatment. Not everybody has the resources to be able to pay for their treatment, and we want to make sure that everybody can have a fair opportunity to survive the disease.
This walk signifies strength.
This walk signifies unity from the community.
And it signifies consideration for an important issue that's occurring.
There's no doubt students and adults will be walking for a good cause. Events like this shed a light on breast cancer awareness, increasing funds, which lead to a higher possibility of new treatments being found.
Run to your pink!
Run to your pink!
Run to your pink!
Run to your pink!
This has been Vanessa Bonilla for Braddock TV.
Japan is known for its eccentric food and culture.
This week, two of our Braddock TV students decided to try some Japanese candies.
You're not eating corn.
I
don't
know what
I'm eating.
It's so true.
Cheers.
Why? It's really good.
Oh.
Oh, that is so spicy.
Really
good.
Okay, so I'm gonna be trying these Pandaro brand butter cookies.
Meerkat juice.
Oh my god, these smell like. It's smells like straight up butter.
Your acne's on the thing.
As fall sports are coming to an end, winter sports are just starting up.
Here's Andrew with this week's sports.
On Sunday, November 11th in Tallahassee, our cross-country team performed at States. The girls placed 6th out of the 24 teams competing. They hope to attend the all-Dade competition. On Wednesday, November 7th was our annual faculty basketball event in which administration and teachers competed head-to-head to see who's the best at basketball. Our very own Gems and Visions dancers made a special performance to keep the energy flowing during halftime. The white team won this year's game.
On November 6th, a majority of the country went out to exercise their right to vote, not only in the Florida races, but in the U.S. midterms as well.
Here's Kamari with World News.
This past Tuesday, November 6th, 2018, the U.S. midterm elections reached its much-anticipated conclusion. With a voter turnout of around 114 million, over 30 million more than the 2014 turnout, this year was sure to be one for the ages. Throughout the chaos of what was to be dubbed the Blue Wave, the GOP was able to retain their majority of the Senate, increasing it, taking Indiana, Missouri, and North Dakota from the Democrats. On the other hand, the Democratic Party gained control of the House of Representatives, having successfully gained more than the 23 seats they needed. The loss of the House will make it more difficult for President Trump to push his policies forward. Meanwhile, on a front closer to home, Republican nominee Ron DeSantis was elected governor of Florida over Democratic nominee Andrew Gillum, after Gillum conceded at around 11 p.m., down by just less than 1% of votes. DeSantis will take office January 8, 2019.
The opportunity to serve as the 46th governor of the great state of Florida is the greatest professional honor of my life. Thank you, the people of Florida, for your faith, your support, and your trust you have placed in me.
In terms of the other major state race, for a Florida Senate seat, Republican Governor Rick Scott leads incumbent Democratic Senator Bill Nelson by less than half a percentage point. As a result, Senator Nelson has requested for a recount in a desperate attempt to come up with the 30,000 plus votes that separate him from retaining his seat.
We believe Senator Nelson has an excellent chance, a much greater than half chance, of being reelected. We will not have a rerun of 2000 when bullying and intimidation ruled and created a rush to judgment so that to this day, many Americans believe that election was unfairly decided. That cannot happen again.
Don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Twitter at @GHB_TV.
And tune into our YouTube channel on Fridays at 10:15 a.m. for new episodes of Braddock TV.
And remember to make it happen
with Braddock TV.